Yeah, India is on the verge of adoption of the massive video-centric data services. 4G is all about mobile broadband, video, services uptake, and also the cloud. 4G, in our view of Reliance Communication, is around a high-speed mobile internet access using a wide channel, RF channel, exploiting the sunken investment of the existing cellular infrastructure. Massive densification of 4G base stations are required to give the ubiquitous experience for continuity of the IP sessions as the users browse on their smartphones and tablets. We as a company have launched our own co-branded tablet for 3G services, and it has seen a good uptake. We have partnered with OTT players like Twitter and Facebook, and we believe that the applications will drive the adoption of the 4G services. The drivers for higher high-speed broadband data services is all around the availability of adequate spectrum in the sub-gigahertz band in 700, 800, 900 megahertz band, and all of that in a carrier aggregation mode of the technological support given by 4G is combined and used. Each operator like us will have access to multiples of 5 megahertz of bandwidth, which will enable us to deliver a techno-economical broadband service business model. We firmly believe that the bandwidth, which is in the form of spectrum, is an essential requirement for any quality of experience-centric high-speed broadband delivery. That coupled with the core network that we have, which is a high-speed MPLS, IP-enabled edge and core network, will enable us to deliver the 4G and 3G services for the aspirational, youthful-centric society of India. Another driver that is required is about the adoption of the smartphone. And the smartphone prices have come down. They are likely to be in the range of 5,000 plus. With the smartphones driving the adoption of data services, we believe that will act as a bigger driver for 3G and going forward in 4G. The timing for 4G adoption in a large scale in India is all about sometime in 2014 plus, because the 4G spectrum auctions have to be done in the 700 megahertz. Spectrum harmonization is one of the fundamental requirements. The harmonization is happening mostly in 1800, 700 and 800 bands for 4G. So if you use these three bands together at the spectrum harmonization, it will give the scale of adoption, and the devices will be available at the affordable rates for a price-sensitive society like India. The spectrum harmonization, the device affordability, the device availability, and exploitation of the existing towers, which are there with massive densification in a span of every 300 meters in urban India, is a big driver for 4G adoption levels in India. Added to that, I think the society is must be willing to afford the services and be willing to pay, starting from 350 rupees plus, going up to 650 rupees plus, if they have to have a 2 Mbps 4G video experience-centric 4G service adoption. I think the affordability, we hope, will be there first for 4G services in dense urban India, then it will be there in the suburban India, and then it will move on to the rural India in that fashion, in the three modes of phased service delivery. With this, we feel that 4G has a few potential. Definitely, and the other relevant things that are felt required is the fiber backhaul. We have the second largest fiber installed base in the country, connecting our points of presence of towers to the core of the network and the edge of the network. That will enable us to offer the services with the lowest latency, and that is what is one of the requirements of video services delivery on the 4G service. This, apart from the national initiative of NOFN from the Government of India, will enable us to go and address the market potential in the rural and suburban India. We look forward for a great future in the data services growth. We feel that is the revolution that will drive the resurrection of the industry, and the affordability has to be in the range of between 350 rupees to 650 rupees, as I already mentioned. With that, we see a promising future for 4G services adoption around 700, 1800 and 800 megahertz bands, apart from the existing 2100 and 900 megahertz bands, which also could be used in the liberalized mode of usage. One of the main things that will come in handy from the technological perspective is the carrier aggregation technology of 4G, MIMO technology of 4G, and self-organizing networks of 4G. These three aspects has to come together so as to give a re-engineering of the radio access network to be able to offer a high quality of experience and an assured quality of service to a mobile broadband user. Thank you.